And I'm very pleased to be stood here today, as I say, at such an impressive event. One that is very important to help our young people determine their future and provide information and particularly advice to anyone that's looking to change.
Well, this is the largest event North Lincolnshire Council has put on for careers. And I think it's really important at this particular time that we do all we can to support our young people and just let them know what there is out there for their future careers. So today we've got 1,600 young people are going to be through our doors till 3 o'clock. And then after 3 o'clock, it's open to the general public, for people if they want to do a career change or just simply looking for a job. And also for the sixth form colleges as well, to come and have a look at their future prospects.
You'll be concentrating on your school like maths or science. If you do well in those, at the moment there's a big shortage of engineers in the country, which will mean you'll be quite...
In North Lincolnshire we know that we've got a real skills challenge going forward. And we've also got a problem where some of our young people primarily used to look to get A-levels and then move away from the area. And we thought that that was partly because they just didn't realise what tremendous opportunities we have to work and live locally in the area. So what we're trying to do is to showcase our international and local businesses to students and show them clear pathways, how they can access local and very well-paid good jobs, and that then also make a contribution to the local economy. We've booked the biggest venue that we could find in North Lincolnshire. It's been such a successful event. We've got over 85 different companies and colleges here, and there were many more expressing interest as well, so we'll have to repeat the event. The employees have certain skills that they're looking for, and normally this is only done through interviews here. They can informally meet with all our local school children, have the discussions, begin to actually explain what those different career paths may be, and it may actually then reinvigorate students to actually do even better at school.
We see it as an ideal opportunity to promote our apprenticeship scheme. We've recruited apprentices for the last 10-15 years at Tata Steel. We see apprentices as being our future. We don't get the opportunity very often for children to have so many companies in one place that they can find out about career opportunities. So it's an ideal opportunity, and yes, something that North Lincolnshire I think has been missing for the past few years. A lot of them are interested about what we can offer, and quite a lot of them are saying that parents and that work for the steelworks, and so they want to follow on in sort of family footsteps. But yeah, in general, really good response from people.
Events like this are exceptionally important for young people in North Lincolnshire. They can shape a person's future by giving them an opportunity to look at all the jobs and careers available here in the local area.
Calcium oxide, the burn line comes out the bottom, which is a product which then goes into mainly into the steel industry. So like Tata Steel, like you've got across there, they use a lot of this. Which goes into the blast furnace and then it combines with the iron ore and it makes steel. In a job, you came to work for our company as an operator, driving a machine.
We've had a really good response so far. We've been fairly busy all through the morning, and the kind of questions they're asking us is what sort of courses they can do at John Legger, and what kind of entry requirements they have to get on the courses to make sure that they're doing the right things at school in the run-up to the transition between school and college.
We've also been very enthusiastic about this event and the providers that are here, and obviously the experience they're getting from it as well, so that's really positive.
We've got an apprenticeship scheme which we run each year. We currently employ six apprentices on a scheme that lasts 12 months with us, obviously working towards full-time position, and we run that each year, obviously looking to find new positions in the company and employ local young people. We've got a couple of interactive games and things on our stand to hopefully get people involved to come talk to us. So we've got a giant Connect 4 which has got sort of job titles all the way through it on the counters so people can see the sort of things that are on offer, and a little game where people put in order the jobs that go with the different departments as well. So hopefully they learn a little bit about what we do.
We do our own sort of events where we go around to schools individually, but this is a really good idea to bring all of the different providers in the county together. We've got a keyboard set up with running Cube and a laptop running Cube-based software, so the kids from the schools, if they're interested in music, they can actually have a go at playing and recording their own pieces of music.
I'm here today because I'm actually representing BEEP, which is the Business Enterprise Education Partnership. The industries in our sector are the process industries on the Humber Bank, the two refineries that we have here in this region, that's Tata Steel here in Scunthorpe, that's the pharmaceuticals such as Novartis, special gases as BOC products, special chemicals such as Crystal. So it is all these big chimneys that you see on the Humber Bank. They can get informed of what kind of type of job roles are available, not just in our sector, but obviously around here in this local economy.
I think it's crucial for years 9, 10, 11 students who are all making decisions about where to go in the future, what careers they want to do, what jobs they want to do, and it gives them the opportunity to make an informed choice and to gather as much information as possible.
As teachers, we can teach the children the syllabus and hopefully get them the grades that they need, but at the end of the day, we are only specialists in our career of teaching. We don't really know about all the other careers. We can advise, but hearing it from the actual experts themselves and the professionals, they're going to get all the answers that they need, and I think they will listen to them a lot more than us.
We've been to the RAF and the courses, and then we've been around like the colleges and the universities.
I've been to the engineering section of the colleges and around the sort of area, the engineering and design.
So you'll feel it when it moves its legs, you'll feel them like go like a train all the way down your hand. The antennae at the front, using them to find a way around. So if you can bring your other hand round, she'll just walk through your hand.
They get a map and a guide beforehand, so we do say focus on the areas that you want to go and visit, something that you're probably interested in but you don't know too much about, and find out what you would need to get into that profession.
Like there's 55 jobs in the RAF and you don't have to be a pilot, so like, I found out what I want to be and what I have to get to be what to be a weapons engineer.
Because the big thing about it is it's not just a 9-to-5 job. Mm. It's not, you know, you leave the house in the morning, go and do your job, you come home at night. Mm. Join the Royal Air Force, get used to the idea that it's a different way of life. Yeah.
I'll just show you an example of a good play. That was a good one.
It's all facing one way.
Right. Which way does it spin? That way.
I'll tell you. That way. Yeah, it's going now. If you can get down below 200, that'd be amazing.
But it's an interesting job. You don't know what you're doing next. I've done it for 14 years, and it's interesting. All right, do you want a couple of that?
How many bones do you think there are on the whole of your back?
Like 24.
Yeah, that's right, 24 from there to there.
Children nowadays, they tend to see the internet more than anything, and they don't really know what's going on in the local area. And they probably think, well, there's not that many jobs around, we don't really know, all we hear is doom and gloom. And then you come here and actually think, there's a lot in this local area and beyond that they probably didn't know anything about beforehand.